Okay guys, it's me again, That Contact Tips. Now we're gonna have part 2 for the B75 with M.2 motherboard. I'm gonna try this motherboard. I'm gonna boot some processor, memory, yan, and then power supply. And then we're gonna test this. But before that, let's intro. Okay guys, let's start. Okay, we have the motherboard, IO shield, SATA cable, processor, memory. Okay, let's do this. Let's put the processor. We're using the Intel i3 2120. It's a second gen processor. Okay. I hope this motherboard is working. Okay, just follow the pattern. And put it like that in a proper place. Then we have the memory. We're using the Kingston 1066 megahertz. We have a 2, the other one is same 1066, same model. We have a 2 gig, total of 4 gig RAM. So we're gonna put this later on this slot before I put the heatsink. So we're gonna use the Prisal Maze heatsink. I have a review on this product. I will put the link below if you want to see that video. See this backplate, it's brand new. It's all brand new. Okay. Gonna take this off for the PS2 connector, and this backward for the LAN port. Let's see. Okay, done. Hey guys, don't forget to like our video and please subscribe and hit the bell icon to notify you if ever we have a video like this. Okay, let's put the bracket Okay. That was fast. Okay, let's put some thermal paste. Okay, the motherboard has specs. It says it support the 2nd gen and 3rd gen processor. I don't know if the K version will also support on this board, or other processor can handle overclocking. But I think this board can't, because this is the entry-level motherboard. But others, if you try it, please comment down below. If you try to use the 3rd gen with the K version. Whoop whoop! The dog's too loud. Whoop whoop! Okay, never mind the dog. So this CPU pan is only a 3-pin. Okay, we have another pan for the chassis pan. After putting all the things, the processor, the heatsink, and the RAM, I will put this on the case. Okay, just follow the pattern for the memory slots. Just push it, push it down. Just like that. Okay, this memory slot can handle 1600 megahertz from 1333 megahertz to 1600 megahertz. Now we are using the Cooler Master power supply, 550 watts. Okay guys, so I'm gonna put this to the case. Then I'm gonna try to boot it. Okay. Oh, American Mega Trends. So we're in the BIOS. So you see the BIOS version is B75NA007. Build date and time. Okay, 9/1/2021. Okay, we go to advanced CPU configuration, data configuration. So we have Intel Core and i3-2120, our processor. Okay, max CPU speed is 3.3 gigahertz. 3.3 gigahertz, okay. So we have a minimum speed of 1600. We go to SATA configuration. So let's see, third gen 3. We have Gen 1, Gen 2, Gen 3. So we set this to default. This is empty. See that ADATA issue 650. Go to chipset, graphics configuration, primary display, so we have the boot. You see the ADATA Asia 650. Okay, UEFI and legacy, then save this. So we're in, so it's working 100%. And we're in the Windows. So that's the Pris Almaze. We CPU Z. We have our processor. CSandy Bridge 65 watts. Socket 1155 LGA 32 nanometer. Okay, so we have 2 core and 4 threads. Mainboard manufacturer OEM, model B75, PCI Express 2.0. Okay, version 1.41. Intel Sandy Bridge. Outbridge Intel Q77 LPCI. Oh, what is that? No button. American Megatrends Corporation version 4.6.5. Okay. Okay, guys, it's working. Yes. So I'm gonna try this. I'm gonna test this for games and other apps. And I'm gonna do another video in this motherboard. I'm testing the M.2 if it is working. Okay. If you want to hey guys, I hope you like this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to notify you if ever I have a video like this. So we'll be having a part 3 for this model. I'm testing the M.2. Okay, thank you guys.